Hi, my name's Jess Meldrum from QMetrix, and welcome to today's episode of 2-Minute Tuesdays.
In today's episode, I'm going to be discussing absolute dates in OfficeConnect. If you haven't watched the previous video on relative dates, I suggest you go back to watch that prior to watching today's episode. As discussed in the previous video, there are two ways we can handle absolute dates. With a pre-built report that is currently referencing relative time, we can use a function called switch to absolute by selecting on the column where the time element was applied and navigating to the review tab. We can right-click on the time element and select switch to absolute. Now we can see that the time element is equal to the month. If we update the report date in workbook properties to a different month, for example, January, and we refresh the report, the absolute column will not adjust according to the report date. Let's create a new report. If we're building a new report that we know need to use absolute time periods, for example, a 12-month July to June forecast analysis, we can simply go into workbook properties and deselect make new time elements relative. Now when we drag in the time elements to the report, we can see that the months are absolute. These absolute time periods will not be driven by changes to the report date. That's it for today's episode. As always, if you'd like to know more details or get further assistance, please reach out. Thanks, and bye for now.